Hello, good morning students. See, welcome back to our e-learning session. And this is your first lecture of third chapter, probability distributions, third chapter, that is normal distribution. And this is initiated by Vidyadis Vidya Sankul under the guidance of Dr. G. M. Sutaria sir. Okay, see, now in our last session we complete up to chapter number 2, that is normal binomial distribution, right? And I hope you all complete the exercise whatever I am giving you in the homework. If you have any doubts, then ask me personally or ask me in WhatsApp. Now see, in today's lecture we will start our next chapter, that is normal distribution, and in that also we will discuss only the regular sums whichever is continue by the government, and whichever the syllabus is cancelled by the government, that we will discuss in our regular lecture. Okay, so right now I am just starting the chapter number 3, normal distribution. And first of all, read the theory. We will understand the theory, what is normal distribution, and then what is the rule for probability of normal distribution, and then we will start our sums. Okay, so here start our lecture. See, now I am reading the first theory and then we will discuss about the sums. What is the theory first? Normal distribution, introduction, then probability destination function. What is that? First of all, the introduction. What is the normal distribution? In the previous chapter, we have studied the probability distribution for the discrete random variable, that we don't do this because we have a cancellation of syllabus, and that is the cancel syllabus district random variable that we don't know. Okay, but now we shall study the probability distribution for the continuous random variable. See, we have to know about the continuous random variable. What is that? We know that if the random variable x can assume any value of the real set R or within the interval of the real set R, then it is called continuous random variable. That we know in the statistics 11th standard. Okay, if a random variable can assume any value between the definite interval a to b, then it is denoted by a less than x less than b. The value of a is between x is between a to b, and we can say that here in the open interval we can write this also. The value of the x is lies between a to b. A is open interval, b is an open interval. A and b, we don't have to take a and b value, we have to take the values between a and b. Okay, so again I am reading that if the random variable can assume any value between the definite interval a to b, then it is denoted by a less than or equal less than x less than b. A function for obtaining probability that a continuous random variable assumes value between specified interval is called probability density function. Underline this full. What is the definition of probability density function? See, underline this. A function for obtaining probability that a continuous random variable assumes value between specified interval, that is specified interval is a to b, right, is called probability density function of that variable, and it is satisfied the following two conditions. We have to follow these two conditions to find out the probability density function. Okay, first condition, see, this condition will apply in our regular sum. So please concentrate these two. First condition, the probability that the values of the random variable lies within the specified interval is non-negative. First condition is that whatever the value is given, the probability lies between these two is compulsory non-negative. Why? Because always probability is positive. Always, no any negative is there in the probability. So you have to keep in mind one thing, that always all the probabilities are positive, non-negative, compulsory. That is the first condition. Again, I am reading that the probability that the value of the random variable lies within the specified interval, that is A to B, within a specified interval, is, that is, these two are compulsory non-negative. That means you can say 0, less than x, less than 1. Yes, this is the correct. The value of x is compulsory positive, non-negative. You can say here 0 to 5. Yes, that is also correct. But you cannot write down minus 3x and plus 4. Here the value of x is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. That is here not possible. In the probability density function, always x will start from minimum from 0 or positive. Non-negative is the first condition. Okay. And the second condition, see that the total probability that the random variable assumes any value within a specified interval is 1 always. Total probability is always 1. See, the value of x never negative, and the answer, that is probability, must be max to max 1 or 0. See, the total probability, always total probability is 1. Total, right? We already seen in the binomial distribution chapter that total probability is always 1. Not more than that, not less than that. Total probability is always 1, right? So the condition, that is also the condition of probability density function. That is, the total probability that the random variable assumes any value between x to any value between the random variable, that means what, between within the specified interval, is 1. Total probability is 1 always. Whatever the value of x is given, the probability is always 1. Total probability, right? Okay, so this is the two condition we have to keep in mind for the probability density function. Now see, thus the probability density function is used to determine probability that the value of the random variable x lies within a specified interval A to B, and it is denoted by P of, here P of, probability of A less than x less than B. The value of x lies between a specified interval, that is A to B, is denoted by this, P into bracket A less than x less than B. Okay, it is necessary to note here that the probability for the definite value of the continuous random variable x obtained by the probability density function is always 0, compulsory. Underline this word also. This is the important theory. See, first the definition of probability density function. In the first paragraph, last two lines is the definition of probability density function. Now the main thing is that two conditions are most important. First condition, x value never negative, total probability compulsory 1. Now the third point, if it is necessary to note here that the probability for the definite variable of continuous random variable, that is x, obtained by the probability density function is always 0, compulsory. That is, see what, P of x is equal to A is equal to 0, starting point always 0. Thus the probability P of A x less than B, and probability A less than or equal to x and less than or equal to B, obtained by the using probability density function are always equal. Here if we are finding out A less than x less than B, or if we are finding out A less than or equal to x less than or equal to B, value of these is always equal. We are considering, see here, what it means of this, not equal to, only less than. Here equal to, that means it is here not included, here included, but the value of starting point, that is A, is always zero. If you are considering A or if you are not considering A, that means here both the values are equal, compulsory. See again, I am reading that it is necessary to note that here the probability for the definite value, a definite value, fixed value to continuous variable x obtained by the probability density function is always 0, that is p of ax is equal to a is equal to 0, starting point, right? Thus the probability of p of a less than x less than b is equal to p of a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b. Both the values are same, both the values are equal, right? By using probability density function are always equal. Okay, so this one. Now, normal distribution. Now the normal distribution, whatever our main chapter starting, introduction. Normal distribution is very important probability distribution. Among the probability distribution for the continuous random variable. See, if we want to find out the discrete random variable, probability of discrete random variable, the binomial distribution is perfect. But if we want to find out the continuous frequency distribution, probability of continuous frequency distribution, then normal distribution is important. Okay, again, if we want to find out the probability of discrete random variable, then binomial distribution is important. But if we want to find out the probability of continuous random variable, then normal distribution is important. That is the main point. See, normal distribution is very important. Probability density distribution among the probability distribution for continuous random variable, and it is very useful distribution for the higher statistical study. If we want to find out the higher statistical study, normal distribution is important. Here we cannot use the binomial distribution. Here at the higher study, at the higher stage, we have to use compulsory normal distribution for the probability continuous random variable. It can be defined as under the definition now here. If x is random variable with mean, that is mu, here mean denoted by mu like this. Whenever we have to write the mean of normal distribution. See, normal mean means what? X bar. Binomial distribution means what? NP. And now, normal distribution's mean is equal to mu. It is denoted by this sign. Just like U, but it is not compulsory U. It is called mu. Okay? Mean. And the standard deviation, that is sigma. It is denoted like this. Standard deviation like this. Okay. So whenever normal distribution, what is mean? That is mu. And what is standard deviation? That is sigma. It is called mu, and this one is called mu. Oh, sorry, standard deviation or sigma. And if the probability density function is, now the formula, probability density function. See that I'm removing here. Main formula, probability density function. F of x is equal to one divided by sigma root 2 pi into e raised to. F of x is equal to 1 divided by sigma root 2 pi. This one is called pi, right? Into e raised to minus 1 by 2 into bracket x minus mu upon sigma all square e raised to this. E raised to, okay. So here, when x value is minus infinity, where minus infinity to plus infinity value of x is between minus infinity to plus infinity, right? Mu is equal to also minus infinity to plus infinity. The value of x, value of mu is between compulsory minus infinity to plus infinity, and the value of sigma compulsory 0 to plus infinity. This one may be negative to positive, and this one compulsory 0 to positive. This is the formula for probability density function. 1 upon sigma root 2 pi into e raised to minus 1 by 2 into bracket x minus mu upon sigma all square. That is the formula, and that is called probability density function. Okay, so remember this formula, where pi is equal to what? Here also, where the value of pi 3.1416 value of pi is equal to 3.1416, and value of e is equal to 2.7183. These are the constant compulsory. The value of pi here, compulsory 3.1416. See, we never use this amount here in this chapter, but we have to know about the value because it will ask in the MCQ. Pi value is equal to 3.1416, and the e, that is e, is equal to 2.17183. Value of these two constant is always these here in the question, in the sums. We don't use these values, but if in the MCQ that these values will ask, then you have to know about the values. What is the value of constant pi and what is the value of constant e? Here pi is equal to 3.1416 and e is equal to 2.7183. Okay. Sorry. So here the values is given, please write down these. These two are constant, and the values of x, mu and sigma are between these two, minus infinity to plus infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity, and sigma 0 to infinity, compulsory. Please write down these. First of all, this is the probability density function. Now this, then x is called normal random variable, and f of x is called probability density function of a normal random variable. Here x is called normal random variable, and f of x full, this one, okay, f of x is called probability density function for the normal random variable. If in the question they ask about the find out normal random variable, probability of normal random variable, then you have to find out this compulsory. If in the question, please underline this compulsory, right? If they ask about the find out the probability of normal random variable, then you have to find out this probability density function. Use the probability density function. They do not ask about the probability density function. They ask in a different way. The different way is what? Here, underline this. You have to find out the probability of normal random variable. Okay, now next point. The distribution of this normal random variable x is called normal distribution and it is denoted by C. New thing. See, the normal distribution is denoted by what? NP. The parameters of binomial distribution is NP. Now the parameters of normal distribution is denoted by mu and sigma square. N into bracket mu comma sigma square, that is variance. Okay, so the distribution of this normal random variable x is called normal distribution, and normal distribution is denoted by N into bracket mu comma sigma square, that is variance, bracket over. Normal distribution is denoted by this way. Okay, so if in the question, see, now you have to see these all these small things, because if the question is regarding the MCQs or the small questions is more in your syllabus, if right now after if government declare that you have to give the answers of objectives, more objectives, then all these things are important. So please underline these small things, right? Normal distribution is denoted by N into bracket mu comma sigma square. Okay, a curve drawn by the considering different values of the normal random variable x and its respective values of the probability density function f of x is called the normal curve and is shown as under. Normal curve. See, in this chapter you have to prepare this normal curve in each and every sum. To find out the answer of the given question, you have to prepare these normal curve in each and every sum. Okay, so first of all, please make your drawing very good, because you have to prepare. See, I cannot draw a very good curve, but you have to be, because you have to present in your examinations. So please draw a normal curve. I will try my best, but please by yourself do this. Please draw a normal curve. See here. It's not normal. First try. Somehow it's normal. I will try my best for to draw a normal curve. See, the first thing, here the curve never touch the baseline, never, compulsory, that is the one main thing. The curve never touch the baseline. Okay, here see, this is f of x normal curve, always it's a bell shape. Okay, here the value is minus infinity and here the value is plus infinity always. And always in the normal distribution, here the mean, median and mode all are equal. Here mean, median and mode x is equal to mu, or here you can say 0 always compulsory. Here the value is equal to 0 and mu we have to denote it here compulsory, right? So mean, median and mode all are equal in normal distribution. We will see in the our properties of normal distribution, but here x is equal to mu, we have to write down x is equal to mu. Here the minus side, here the plus side, here minus infinity, here the plus infinity. Okay, the value of minus value here we have to write down here, x plus value we have to write down on the right side, right? Okay, as shown in the above diagram, normal curve is completely bell shaped compulsory, which shows that it is symmetric distribution. Compulsory, normal distribution is always symmetric distribution, that's why it is called normal distribution. Otherwise it is called skewed frequency distribution. Skewed distribution is never bell shaped, and whenever the normal distribution is there, it is always bell shaped, and that's why it is called a normal distribution, or you can say symmetric distribution. Okay, skewed distribution is never be normal. Okay, see now on the next page, standard normal variable and the standard normal distribution. See, compulsory read this full first page in your homework, please read that, because it is very important, and what whenever we are underlying, you have to remember that all the points that is important for the examination. So please underline and remember and learn that particular topic or particular points. Okay, now the next page, standard normal variable and the standard normal distribution. If x is a random normal variable with mean, that is mu, and standard deviation, that is sigma, then random variable z is equal to, now the next point is random variable, that is capital Z is equal to x minus mu upon sigma. This is again one formula, and it is also important we have to use this formula. See, probability density function is only used in the short sums. Probability density function formula, that is first page, is only used in the short sums. Now in the long sum, that is in the 4-mark sum, we have to use this formula, random variable z is equal to x minus mu upon sigma, right? It's called standard normal random variable. It's called standard normal random variable. Okay, and its probability density function is given below. Now the probability, see here, first probability density function for, see that probability density function for continuous random variable, and here the probability density function for standard normal random variable. Normal random variable and standard normal random variable, two are the different things. Please write down that. Normal random variable or random variable f of x is equal to what? 1 upon sigma square root 2 pi into bracket e raised to minus 1 by 2 into bracket x minus mu upon sigma all square. This is the formula for normal random variable. Right, probability density function. Now the probability density function of standard, the word extra added is standard normal random variable. Now it is denoted as f of z. Here it is denoted f of x. Now standard normal random variable is denoted as f of z, and the formula is 1 upon root 2 pi. Into e raised to minus z minus 1 by 2 z square. Here standard deviation, and here z, both the values are cancelled here in the standard normal random variable. See, the formula is almost same. Here f of x 1 upon sigma root 2 pi into e raised to minus 1 by 2 x minus mu upon sigma. Now what is the value of z random variable? That is x minus mu upon sigma. Now it is, if we want standard normal random variable, then f of z is equal to, here sigma is cancelled, 1 upon 2 root pi, right, into e raised to minus 1 by 2. Here the value of z, x minus mu upon sigma, that's why z square. Just remove here standard deviation, and here value of z is there, that's why just write down the z, nothing else. Very easy and very common. Normal random variable density function. See, the density function of random variable, normal random variable, is this, and the density function of standard normal variable is, random variable, is this. So these are the two formulas. These are the two formulas for normal random variable density function and standard normal variable density function. Okay, and the value of z here again between minus infinity to plus infinity. Minus infinity z less than z less than plus infinity. So here it can be seen here that the probability density function of a standard normal variable is a normal density function with mean 0. Always mean is equal to 0 and the standard deviation is equal to 1. Here in the standard normal random variable density function, mean is equal to mu is equal to 0 and the standard deviation is equal to 1. Always, if the normal random variable given, then density function is this, and the value of x is minus infinity to plus infinity, value of mu is between minus infinity to plus infinity, value of standard deviation is between 0 to plus infinity. Okay, but here in the standard normal random variable density function, the value of mu, that is mean, is equal to 0 always, and the value of standard deviation is always 1, right? See, note, during the further study of this chapter, we shall call normal variable as equal to x. Normal variable is equal to x, and instead of normal random variable x, normal variable or normal random variable, both are same, that is x. Okay, and the standard normal variable that is z, here we say that instead of standard normal random variable that is z, normal random variable that is x, but random word we are removing, and that's why normal variable is x and standard normal variable that is z. Here for the further studies you have to keep in mind, only the word random is removed. Normal variable is equal to x and standard normal variable is equal to z. Okay, that is the note. By the point plotting different values of standard normal variable z and its respective value of f of z here on graph, on graph paper, a completely bell-shaped curve is obtained as under. See this one again, completely bell-shaped, minus infinity, plus infinity, and here z is equal to 0. Only the change is now the value of x and mu is not there, the value of z is equal to 0. Z is equal to 0, here the value of minus z, here the value of plus z, compulsory, right? Value of z if negative we have to denote it here, value of z if positive we have to denote it here. This curve is called standard normal curve and it is symmetric to both the sides of z is equal to 0. Both the side it is symmetric, okay? Now, see that third point. First of all, I am giving you here 1 or 2 minutes. Please read this first full page and the second half page up to the 3.2. Please read standard normal variable and standard normal distribution. Please read that. What is probability density function? What is random variable? New words are there. Please read carefully. Then we will discuss about the next topic, that is third topic, method of finding out the probability area from the tables of the standard normal curve. Okay, so first of all, read that. I am giving you here 1 or 2 minutes for that. See, now I hope you read that. Now third 3.3 point, method for finding out the probability, that is area from the tables of standard normal curve. See the area between these two, these area, see the total, this is the total probability, this is this in this curve, total probability, always total probability is what? First condition, that is total probability is always 1, right? So in this curve the total probability is 1 and it is exactly between the in the middle, that's why we can say the area between these from middle to this side, and from here, middle to this side, middle to this side and middle to this side is here 0.5 and here also 0.5, because total is 1, total area, total probability is always 1. Here the half portion, that's why 1 and half, That's why 1 half is equal to 0.5 and here 1 half that is also 0.5. The area between these two is 0.5 and 0.5. Okay. We know that the normal curve is a curve of a normal density function and it can be seen as under, yes, the area, that is probability of the shaded region between the curve and x-axis is equal to 1. Always, these and these, between the shaded and the curve, shaded between the curve and the x-axis is equal to 1. This one is the x-axis and the curve. Between that, the shaded area is total probability and total probability is always 1, right? The normal curve of the normal variable x is symmetrical about the mean on both the side. Compulsory here, mu is there, x is equal to mu, right? From the mean, both the side it's symmetric. Now, about the mean, mu on the both the side and has the perpendicular line at the point x is equal to mu. Perpendicular line x at the x is equal to mu. This one is the perpendicular line, right? On x axis divides the area, in two equal proportion. Divide the area, that is probability of the normal curve, in two equal parts. The area, that is probability to right side of x is equal to mu. Right side of the x is equal to mu as well as the left side of the x is equal to mu on the both the side is 0.5. This side 0.5, this side 0.5, right? And is denoted by, see this one. This side is 0.5 and this side also 0.5, both the side equal. So it is denoted by P of x greater than or equal to mu. P of x greater than or equal to mu is equal to 0.5. Mu and greater value, mu's value is equal to here on the perpendicular, and greater value is equal to, the area is equal to 0.5. And same way, less than, mu less than or equal to, value of probability of x less than or equal to mu is also 0.5. this side the value is 0.5 area, and this side the value of is also 0.5. this one is the this side. See, I'm writing these on the on this side, so it is better to know. Total probability is always 1, and here probability of x greater than or equal to mu is equal to 0.5. this side is called probability of x greater than or equal to mu, greater than or equal to mu, and this side is called probability of x less than or equal to mu. Both the side the value is equal, that is 0.5. okay, now say in normal, next paragraph, in the normal curve, probability that the value of the normal variable x is lies between mu, that is mean, and its any specified value, that is called a. The value is lies between a greater than or mu, or you can say value a is greater than mu, this one, right, can be shown by the area of the shaded region between the x-axis and the perpendicular lines. X is equal to mu, that means here this part only. See here in the textbook what they say, if the value of a is equal to here, a is here, x is equal to a. Now what? See, if the value is given, that is A, from mu to A, here this is the mu and here the A. A is greater than mu, that's why this one is the shaded area is the value, right? See here, in the normal curve, I'm reading again, in the normal curve probability that the value of the normal variable x lies between mean, that is mean, and the it's any specific value A between mu and A is greater than mu, can be shown by the area standard normal region, in the standard normal region, right? Between the x-axis and the perpendicular lines, x-axis and perpendicular line, between these, this is the area, okay? And it can be shown as under this one, is in the notation, this can be shown as, see, how can we write this? We can write P of x mu, sorry, P of mu less than or equal to x less than or equal to a, from mu to a, right? In the notation we can say probability of mu to a, mu less than or equal to x less than or equal to a, from this to this, we have to find out the probability of from this to this, okay? In notation we can write like this. For the obtaining area under the normal curve, first of all, normal variable x is changed into standard normal variable z. We have to convert this value of x into z. What is the formula for z? Again, x minus mu upon sigma. We have to write down the value of x, then mu, and then sigma. And convert it, the value of x, into the value of z. Okay? Change it. Normal variable z. By considering different positive values of the standard normal variable z, a table is prepared for obtaining area under the normal curve for z 0 to z. Table is already there. We have to use the table which is already given in the last page of this textbook. And this value, always value of z is between 0 to z. Value of z is between here the area. See, the table is prepared for obtaining area. Table is there. Here table is given to obtaining the area under normal curve for 0 to z. And by using this table, the area can be obtained. By using this table, we can find out the area. See, this area, how we find out? First of all, value of x, that is mu. And the value of a specified value of x is given. Mu and specified value of x is given. Between these two, we have to write down like this. Mu less than or equal to x, less than or equal to a. And now convert it by using this formula. We convert this value into z. And then use the table which is given in the last page of this textbook. And the table, in the table 0 to z value is given. From that table, we have to find out the value of z, and on the basis of that, that is our answer of this area. See, this is full up to this to this is 0.5. From this to this, it is 0.5. But up to this, what is exact value that we can find out from the table? And practically, we will see in our illustration how we find out the value of z, or you can say value of area of the probability given, or probability how we find out, that we will see in our regular practical question. Okay, so here the note is given, and what is the note? A table for different values of the standard normal variable is given on the last page of this book. Yes, suppose probability is given, and the value or the x value, or how we find out the value of x, is given. See, read this only, because this we will discuss not in a example form, but in a practical form, that is from illustration 1. We will discuss this part last. This part, suppose, no, we don't have to suppose, we have a specific value in illustration 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are using that particular value and we are doing these sums and we are understanding this value of z on the basis of actual practical questions. So this part, okay, this part you just have to read, you don't have to understand. But up to this, up to the note, you have to read all these things. Please read all the 2.5 pages. That is first topic 3.1, normal distribution, introduction, probability density function, then standard normal variable and standard normal distribution, and the third topic, method for finding out the probability, that is area here, and from the tables of standard normal curve. Just read all these things. Now practically, how we find out the area, that we will discuss in illustration, from illustration 1 to all the illustration. So the last part after the node, we are not discussing about that because we have to see the practically in illustration number 1. Okay, so here I am complete my lecture. So read your homework for today is only read and understood 2 to 3 times. These 2 and 2.5 pages. If you understand these 2.5 pages, then you can understand illustration number 1 and so on. Okay, so please read carefully 2 to 3 times these 2.5 pages. And here I am complete my lecture. So thank you class. Have a nice day. Bye bye.